1051.
Power 105.1 is the Breakfast Club. Straight out of jail.
Fresh out of jail, out on bail.
Who? Free DJ Paul.
Free DJ Paul. DJ Paul's in the building.
What's up? What's up?
So what did you have on you, Paul?
Man, just a taser, man. You know.
That's what my father got arrested for here. He got arrested here last year. He tased somebody at the Jets game. I'm from South Carolina. He's from South Carolina, too.
For real?
Yeah, so tasers are illegal in South Carolina. Carry them all the time. So he had
in
on
South Carolina?
Yeah. Tases illegal.
He tased a whole bunch of people at the Jets game. He
just, for real?
Yeah, he got into a fight at the Jets game. Some guys tried to jump him because he's a Cowboy fan. They was playing the Jets, and he tased him. And he got arrested for it. The charges got dropped, though.
Yeah, well, yeah. So I didn't even taste nobody. I just had to something.
You just had an open bottle of Corona on you, right?
Yeah, but I wasn't drinking it, dog. I was finna throw it away. It was empty.
Where were you?
Bad luck.
Where was I?
39th Street.
You was on 39th Street walking around with an empty bottle of Corona and a taser?
Yeah.
You lucky you ain't get shot. You ain't hear about the black guy a couple months ago who was smoking a blunt. Police ended up shooting him.
For real?
You damn right.
That's crazy.
But he started acting crazy, though.
Where were you coming from?
Man, I don't even want to say where I was coming from. I don't want to disrespect the people that I came from. But I was coming from a little event.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
And you just walked out the place with the Corona in your hand.
No, I didn't walk about it. I got a Corona after I left it.
Oh, for the bodega?
No, what's that?
Okay.
Corner store. From
that's
the
like
corner
a corner store.
Store.
Oh, yeah, from the corner store.
Yeah, we call it a bodega.
Yeah.
Yeah,
bodega, you know, that's a very New York term.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm like, what the hell is a bodega?
Yeah, they don't say bodega.
Sounds like
other
the
places.
Event that I was at, a bodega.
No serious charges, though.
Yeah, no, just a misdemeanor, you know what I'm saying?
Better so how did they know you had a taser on you? They searched you because they found because you had the bottle?
Yeah.
They could just do that?
He had that big book bag and a bottle. And if you were a cop, you'd be like, oh, he probably tried to blow Times Square up. Mm. Let me search that bag and taser.
Yeah.
Better taser than a pistol.
They saw the beer. But I had a black bag over it. Mm-hmm. So I don't even know how they knew it was a beer. I guess they just figured it was a beer.
Mm-hmm.
They were right.
They right.
So you can't refuse to let somebody search you?
No, don't they got the no frisk? No. What's the thing called?
Yeah, stop.
Stop and frisk?
Yeah. Stop and frisk.
Oh, man.
That's crazy.
It wasn't with a bunch of people?
No.
He's
man.
A
no, you're right.
Wouldn't you want to stop and frisk him if you saw him?
Well, that's different. If he's not a cop.
Yeah.
Depends
so if
who you
he
ask.
Wants to do that, that's
depends
different.
Who you ask.
Shut up.
And if he's known as a cop in these streets.
Hey, shut up.
An informant.
Shut up.
Crazy.
And then you said that you should have just had pepper spray. Is that legal?
They said the pepper spray would have been cool.
It's a certain kind, though. I forgot it's a certain kind of mace.
You
of pepper
had pepper
spray,
spray and a taser?
No. Oh. I didn't have pepper spray.
He said he should have had pepper spray.
I should have had pepper spray. You know what I'm saying?
At least you didn't have a pistol. Pistols are mandatory 3.5 years in New York.
Yeah, I know where the hell I walk. And I got a gun permit, but I wouldn't bring no gun to New York.
Hell no.
Everybody
no.
knows that.
I ain't that stupid.
But you're right. It's not fair, because how do you know you're not allowed to have a taser? Some places you are allowed to have
one.
Yeah,
a lot of places. Most places where I got houses there, you can have them. But
where I got houses at, you like that, right?
Is that the stupidest thing you've ever gotten arrested for?
No, hell no. I got arrested for way stupid stuff than that.
Like what? Stupidest thing you ever got arrested for?
Man, you know, the stupidest thing I ever got arrested for is I shouldn't even got arrested. I was riding. You know when you get out of school? Well, I got kicked out of school. Mm-hmm. But I still was in school age. So once I got kicked out of school, I was still right up to the school.
Damn, you know, right. That's where the girls was at.
Yeah.
There's nothing to do during the day. Everyone else is at school.
Yeah, so I hit the strip after school, and I was in a box Chevy. You know what a box Chevy is.
Absolutely.
I was from a box Chevy with Bones and Vogues on it. Gold Bones and Vogues,
okay.
And rag top, quarter top. And the police pulled me over. And he pulled me over, and he's like, I don't want to see you up here no more. You don't go to school. I don't want to see you up here no more. You got kicked out of here. I'm like, all right, I want to come back. And he said, sign this paper. And if I see you back up here, I'm going to turn it in. If I don't see you back up here, I won't turn it
okay.
in. He turned it straight in.
Damn.
The same day. So I didn't even know. So next day I know the police come to my house like, you've always been in court like 10 days ago. Like you.
So you had a warrant.
Yeah.
Well, that's your fault because you shouldn't have signed
up.
I'd be like, man, F you, truancy officer.
I shouldn't have signed.
You see me out here riding clean in my box Chevy?
Yeah, I shouldn't have
signed.
Well,
he wasn't in school at the time, so he didn't know any better, you know?
Mm. Yeah, I shouldn't have signed. I signed it, and that was the stupidest thing I went to jail for. I'm sitting up here like, I got
that's
a warrant. I'm only 17. 16, I got a warrant.
Now, we just had your guy Juicy J up here the other day.
Uh-huh.
He was talking so much smack about you.
Everything cool with y'all? It ain't no beef between y'all, right?
Hell no.
What was he saying, Charlamagne?
He ain't say nothing about no DJ Paul. Yeah, come on, man. He probably just got off the phone with Juicy.
No, but you guys did finish your album together, but I don't know. You said you don't know when it's coming out, because
yeah, we would do another album though. We're talking about doing another album like next year, because mm-hmm. we did that album like 4 years ago or something.
Okay. When you heard Bands Make a Dance, you called you. She's like, man, why you ain't put me on that, man? That could have been us together, man. 3-6, man. We got the Oscar.
No, man. I mean, we're grooving. When we do Three Six Mafia songs, we do Three Six Mafia songs. But then we do our solo stuff.
Got you.
Yeah, so, no, man.
All right. And you have something coming out next week, right?
Yeah, October 22nd.
Okay. That's a person of interest.
Yeah, it's a movie and an album.
Oh, a movie and an album.
Yeah.
What's the movie about?
About a girl stalking me on Twitter, and she started stalking me in real life.
Is that
a true story?
No, it's based on true events.
Oh.
So it is kind of a true story. So somebody was stalking you on Twitter?
No, not me. I just know some people that have talked about stuff like that.
It's crazy, man, because 3 Six Mafia has been so self-sufficient for so many years. I mean, even with the independent movies, the independent music, would you ever even think of being with a major again?
No, man, major's too much problems. You know, that's why so many artists do mixtapes these days, because you with a mixtape you can be free and do whatever the hell you want to do. Mm-hmm. And once you got the label, that's why a lot of artists, I was just talking about this actually, where a lot of artists mess up at, like, you know, the artists that have the hottest mixtape out.
Yeah.
Like the 10 hottest mixtapes out, like they bring out so many mixtapes these days, I don't know how they do it. But I have like the hot mixtapes for like 3 years in a row. And then they bring out an album, and the album sucks.
Suck, yeah.
Yeah, because you get in there and all them suits be like, oh, well, you don't need, you know, shouty blah, blah, blah from South Bank, Atlanta, whatever, to make the beats for this. You need to go get this person. You need to hire this person. This is the hottest producer out. He produced Beyonce, blah, 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 whatever. Not saying her, but... And then they talk you into thinking all that crap, and then you'd be like, yeah, you're right, I do need to get him, because I can afford to get beats from him now. And then when you bring that out, you know, dudes in the streets be like, what the hell is this?
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
It don't even sound like the dude I grew to like.
Yeah, yeah. So.
But can you make money off of mixtapes?
You can get shows.
Right, you get shows, but you...
Yeah, but I don't really do the mixtape thing, so I ain't really the dude to talk to about that. Yeah, I put out 3 mixtapes in my life. Well, you know, back in the day, I had the mixtapes out before 3 Six Mafia. But, like, you know, after, and once the little mixtapes got back hot, I put out, like, yeah, three or four.
Right.
Between now and 2008.
Y'all would always drop albums.
Yeah, yeah. Just drop albums. That's why I put out this album that's coming out. It's an underground album. Like, man, I'd rather make this $8 a unit.
Word up.
Instead of keep bringing out all this free music. Because it's cool to put out the mixtapes, but if you keep giving the people free music for the rest of your life,
that's
you
what they're going to want.
Yeah, that's what they're going to want. Yeah. Like, I took a mixtape and I did a no DJ version and put it out for sale, and somebody got upset. They're like, man, how you going to sell us a mixtape? I'm like, why not?
That's true. Yeah.
Now, what is that? Is that a diamond on your eye?
There's two.
Two of them.
It's dermals.
How
many people have you killed to get that?
No,
how is that in your face like that?
It's a hook that they put in your face, and then you screw the diamonds into the hook.
So you can take that out and everything?
You can take the diamonds out. You can't take the hook out. That stay in your face.
Is that really painful when you got it done?
Just for like 1 second when they had to stab it in and dig it in there. And then,
at one point, y'all used to have stuff like that, then everybody was like, 3 Six Mafia worships the devil. That's why they got the 3 Sixes, they got the tattoos and diamond earrings in their face.
Yeah.
Do you worship the devil?
No, I don't.
Oh. I never asked him.
Believe in God, man. Believe in God all to the fullest.
Absolutely.
Now, Person of Interest, is that a horror movie? Because I know you have
talked about it. It's a horror comedy movie. Mm-hmm. Comedy horror, you know what I'm saying? We didn't even write the movie. I just brought my boys out, and we just rolled cameras. We planned on making just videos to come with the album, and then we end up coming up with this idea to make all the videos marry together to be a movie, and we just put skits in between all of it, so it'd be like movie, then video, movie, video, movie, video.
Now, we're talking to DJ Paul. Now, one time you were spending money like it was growing out your backyard.
Yeah, still do that.
Now, where's the majority of the money coming from? Because at one time you were buying phantoms, you were buying houses, jewelry.
I had three phantoms.
What the hell?
Why do you need three for? Yeah,
you need three phantoms. Yeah,
not
three
at the same time.
Oh, okay.
No, nah, hell no. That would be too stupid. No, not at the same time. Man, I was lucky, man. I came out in the 90s. Mm. I came out right when SoundScan, you know, really got popular, when artists knew what SoundScan was. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know for like the first 2 weeks. And then that's when I started hearing about SoundScan. They were like, this new thing just came out in the SoundScan. I'm like, what the hell is that? And they were like, you can tell how many records you sold. I'm like, what? Mm-hmm. And then we started finding out. So, you know, a majority of all those old 3 Six Mafias we had put out independently. Mm-hmm. You know, we're getting like $8 a unit. So, you know, you sell a half a million copies at $8. That's a lot of money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And so, y'all had other artists.
Yeah, we had
y'all
other
keeping
artists.
All their money too.
No.
Yeah, and then you had the Choices movies. How did that made you guys some money too?
Yeah, Choices. We got we sold that for $20. The label gave us $10 off that. Mm. We did over 200,000 copies of those.
Mm. And after y'all won the Oscar,
three movies.
After y'all won the Oscar, how did things change financially?
Oh man, that's when it got crazy, man. Which you know, we did the first thing we did after that was the Rocky Balboa movie. Mm-hmm. We did the theme music that ran through the whole movie.
And the last Rocky with Antonio Tava?
Yeah.
Okay.
Antonio Tava was a good friend of mine, so we did that last Rocky. We got $500,000 for that.
Damn.
Because they used it in the commercial and everything. So
you think Antonio Tava?
Songs. We had a song in the last Will Ferrell movie, Election.
Okay. All produced by you.
Yeah, man, Juicy.
So why would you see? I wouldn't want to rap no more. I would just stay behind the scenes like RZA. Just keep producing.
Yeah. People still buy his albums.
I just do it just because I like hearing my music.
Right, he enjoys it.
Yeah, I'm a fan of myself. And then when I sit up and I listen to some of the music out, you know, I feel sorry for the listeners. I'm like, man, you gotta listen to this.
Right.
Like, I would kill myself if I had to listen to just some of the hip hop.
What don't you listen to now? What don't you like? Because you said you
I don't really listen to rap. You know, I got some rappers that I do listen to. Like, I like Waka Flocka because, you know, he kept like.
You got that old 3-6 energy.
Crunkness.
I'm assuming you like Gucci.
I like Gucci. Yeah. Gucci on my single. But, you know, some of the stuff I don't really mess with. But it's cool, though. It's something for everybody.
Is it strange to you to see people accept the South the way that they have? Because y'all grew up in a time when ain't nobody was messing with the South except for the South, especially up north.
Yeah, especially up north. Yeah, it was crazy. That's when I knew we made it, when they started playing this on New York, in the radio in New York. Mm-hmm. But these days, you have to play South. Mm-hmm. Like, you know.
It's the only thing out.
Yeah, it's out there.
What else out?
And even people in other coasts, you know what I'm saying, sound like South.
Absolutely.
Sound like South. So, you know.
You didn't get all Hollywood when you guys were in L.A., moved to L.A.?
No, man. We kept the same, still peeing outside by the tree.
Didn't you see that reality show? So mad they got rid of that reality show.
What happened with that? MTV just said, you don't want to do it no more?
No, what happened was the
the neighbors didn't want to do it.
Yeah, exactly. No, the producer that was over, he had got into a little deal with some people at MTV and whatever. And so it was his show, so everything went out the door with him.
Gotcha.
And that was a good show.
Would you do another one? Another show?
We did another show. What,
was that the cooking?
Yeah, the cooking show like 2 years ago, whatever, Famous Food. Mm-hmm. Then I'm working on
and
this.
Yeah, don't you have some type of rub for your meat?
Yeah.
What?
Rub for your meat?
Rub for your meat?
Rub for your meat. I got some rub for your meat.
Was it masturbation cream? What's that, masturbation cream? What is rub for your meat?
I got a barbecue sauce and a barbecue rub out. You know, something I did on the side for the fun. You know what I'm saying? DJ Paul, BBQ.com. We got the sauce. And we got some little cooking videos and stuff. Gotcha. But that's how that whole cooking show, the restaurant show, came from that, because I filmed a cooking show that VH1 had filmed for us. But then once it done, I feel that they didn't really want to compete with, like, Food Network or any of that. Right. So they said, we want to do something with you in the cooking genre, but not a cooking show. So
you should do the Food Network then.
Yeah, I should. I'm trying to get to that. That's one of the reasons why I'm up here. I always go to the Food Network festivals and different stuff like that. I know a lot of people from the Food Network.
You know, our producer's a chef over here. He's a real chef.
He hates this job. He really wanted to be a chef.
He really wants to be a chef. He
We've never had any chefing of his cooking.
I hung out last night. I hung out with Sonny. Y'all know Sonny.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I hung out with Sonny and Dr. Ann.
I don't know who Dr. Ed is. I know Sonny.
He like a nutritionist.
Okay.
You know Dr. Ed? He knows him. He knows.
Do you prefer doing business with black people or white people?
Oh, my goodness.
It depends on if I'm getting paid from them or not. If I'm finna get paid from them, I'd rather do it with white people.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Why?
If I'm just hanging out with them, then black people probably.
Yeah,
not white people, too. I like hanging out with white people.
But why?
This is strictly on a business perspective.
Our business, white people.
Why?
Because they're going to pay you.
You damn right.
Black people don't pay you?
Not all the time.
And it's more money with white people.
Yeah.
And they open you up to new opportunities and new things.
Yeah, because white people got money to spend. Black people don't really have it. Yeah, I mean, we don't have it. We wasn't really born to be rich.
This is a shame.
Absolutely. It's not a shame. It's the truth.
That's the truth.
Now, we got questions from Twitter now. People want to know, what was the deal with your aunt? Were you born like that? Or?
Oh, man, a finger up virgin.
And it snapped off.
It didn't snap off. It tightened. She was too tight, man. And she just
get out of here.
She locked up. On
you know, I thought you were born like that. But Angela, you said no, it was an accident.
Yeah, it was when I was bad. I was bad when I was a kid.
You shot it off?
What, they chopped your helmet off and steal it or something?
No. I put it like this. I lived. He died.
All right, no story. All right, okay. So DJ Ball's here. Ball's got a new album coming out next week.
All right.
October 22nd, a person of interest, man. You know, it's so funny, when I got arrested, the police asked me, they were like, what are you doing up here? I was like, I'm promoting the album. I got to do radio in the morning, matter of fact, so y'all need to let me up out of here. He said, well, look at it like this. He said, now you got something to talk about when you get to the radio. he was like, what's the name of your album? I said, a person of interest. He said, really?
That's what you put out there.
As they was driving through the neighborhood and saw a suspicious looking black man, you have a person of interest walking down the street with a bottle in his hand.
And a big ass backpack.
I was like, man, DJ Paul canceled on us. And then our producer was like, look, I heard he got arrested. This was before it came out in the news.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, he gonna run that I got arrested story because he's late. But then you really did get arrested. So.
Yeah. I was telling him, I said, man, I gotta go to the radio station anymore. They're like, oh, you be out of here in a minute.
In a minute.
Yeah, right.
Sign this paper.
All right, it's DJ Paul. It's The Breakfast Club. It's Power 105.1.